Oh, unit, okay.
Okay, and I'm not sure if the mic was on before this point, but basically, if it wasn't, I'm sure it is now. But we're doing a trip from Atlantic City International to Norfolk International Airport. It'll be a VFR day, but we're flying it like it's IFR. Before, the only thing I did before the mic was inadvertently shut off was the outside view, top down, so position out here by runway 4 with the bird's eye view, and going back and getting everything set up here. So that's where we are at this point. Let's see here. Okay, so our parking brake is set overhead. We went there, we turned on battery 1, battery 2. Cockpit lighting is on. Emergency lights are armed. And we turned on the navs and the red beacon, and I guess for our purposes, somebody wanted me to cover, they emailed me. They wanted me to cover the electrical system a little bit. So we'll go ahead and start the APU. And she should start firing up. She is. We're waiting for the APU to come up to 100%, and we're at 90 now. Okay. Bleed APU valve is open. Very good. So yeah, as far as systems, they just wanted me to just kind of go over a couple things here. I go to systems, electric, and basically right now, this is the electrical system. We have AC bus 1, alternating current bus 2. We can see our transformer rectifier units. These are used to step up or step down voltage, depending on whatever accessories are. If we were using a ground power start, then this would be active here, but we can see that the APU is active, 115 volts, 400 hertz, and this is actually giving our system electrical power at this point. And then I'm going to keep that up, keep that screen up, and I'm going to go to engine 2. And we're going to make sure that our ignition is set to auto, opening the ignition cover, and we'll start engine 2. Now what's going to happen is you're going to see the electrical system from the engine take over. It's not going to take over, it's going to just join in. But we need the APU to get this engine started, because there's a lot of electrical energy that needs to be produced in order to start everything. So now you can see engine 2 is up. So engine 2 is up. Let's just take a look at some indications here. Okay, so engine 2 is up and running. Pull up our electrical system again. Open the cover off at 1, pull that open, and we will make sure our ignition is auto. You can see engine 1 coming alive. engine 1 is up and running. And we can see here in the electrical system diagram, engine 1 is up, engine 2 is up, producing electrical power. And so we don't need the APU anymore at this point. So we'll go to our overhead, and we'll shut this down and we'll watch this disappear. And simultaneously power down. So the APU is no longer providing electrical energy for us. Our engines are. So we don't just call them engines, we call them power plants. So the APU is shut down. Electric pump A. Now another thing I like to do is I turn on the hydraulic PT in here. And with this, it helps me move the trim tab a lot faster at this point because the system is very cold right now. And this gets everything kind of going. This is very, very slow, and it may appear like it's moving slow now, but it moves a lot slower when this thing is off. And 5.9 is the takeoff setting for trim. Recommended takeoff setting. Yeah, but it's like super slow when this thing is off, so this helps get the hydraulic system going. And set that up because it just takes a long time. We'll switch this back to auto. And normally, before everything starts up, everything should be in the 12 o'clock position, all the knobs and switches. The battery come on, you know, they come into the 12 o'clock position, but the AC pump one goes to auto. Initially, the APU controls in the 12 o'clock position, and all these switches are in the 12 o'clock position except electric pump A of the hydraulic system. Okay, so now that we got that taken care of, let's go ahead and go to our map here. So we'll see what's going on here. We'll turn on our nav aids, we'll turn on our airports, and we'll turn on our waypoint identity. We'll go ahead and set our initially we're going to be going to ATR, which is Waterloo VOR. We haven't set it up yet. We are about to. So at this point, what we need to do is let the aircraft know where she is. And I'm sorry, I'm not being chauvinistic or anything. I don't want any emails. Why it's got to be a girl? I don't want to hear that. All right, nav. Nav ident. Position in it. Atlantic City. Flight plan. We're going to K is the United States prefix for all airports, but we're going to Oscar Romeo Foxtrot. That is our destination. Alright, our first VOR is ATR. SP block. Salisbury. Jamie intersection. Juliet Alpha Mike India Echo. Cape Charles VOR Charlie Victor. I could change this later, but I'm actually looking for the ILS 23. It's the airport, which is Cape Charles. Yeah, I guess we can use Cape Charles. We'll use Cape Charles. And we're not going to use Drone 1 or Turks 2. So back to, just click Arrival, Insert. And make sure we don't have any discontinuities. We do not. And let's go ahead and listen to ATIS. Okay, so we're going to be using runway 31. We'll slide this over a little bit. And back to nav, departure, 31, insert. Alright, we've inserted that. So RW means runway 31, Kilo, Alpha Charlie Yankee, Atlantic City. Activate that. Alright, perf, net. Next page. New reserve, 2000. Next page, zero fuel weight 55199, and it'll give us a gross weight after it calculates that. And just for our purposes as well, we're at 20,700 in a gauge. I'm just making a note of that. Check it for takeoff because I'm actually doing a fuel consumption. Okay, so I'm setting up our cruising altitude, which is 12,000. Runway heading. The heading button at 31. So it locks us in at 215 knots. It just automatically stop there. Okay, let's get pushed back and back by the ground service equipment, and we can taxi on, get on out of here. nice and easy taxi. Way. This is going to be taxiway Papa. This is taxiway P. You can look at your airport diagram. And we're going to make a right on Bravo. So let's go back to our virtual cockpit view. Taking Papa to Bravo to runway 3-1. This sim is not updated, but we are on, trust and believe, we are on Hotel Papa. I just saw the sign, I was like, what? But if the current, airdrome sketch, or airport diagram, this is Papa. And we're gonna make a right turn on Bravo. I just looked at that, it said Hotel. That needs to be updated. Let's see if this says Bravo. Yes, it does say Bravo. Okay, so. Nonetheless, the airport diagram layout, the airport layout, the actual taxiways are good and current. But, that took me for a little bit. What the hell? Okay, Bravo continues with the left turn on the 3-1. We have the option to make a right on Kilo if we want to. And there's runway 3-1.